DrawThings, the image and video generator for Mac and iOS. It's free on the app stores. DrawThings is written in Swift, not Python, so it's optimized for Apple Silicon. And recent updates include this stunning video preview. This is how video should look on a Mac. Under the machine settings, we have options for the exported video. It's H.264 or a couple of Apple ProRes formats. Exporting videos is easier too, either directly from the thumbnail or use the Save To button at the top of the canvas. And there's a new option, click and hold, or option click, to extract individual frames. In the history window, we can select multiple animation clips and export as a single video. Now, originally, all rendering was done locally using open source AI models, but these models get larger every 6 months. They need more RAM and they run slower. So now there's an optional DrawThings offload server for Mac and Linux with NVIDIA GPU. You can set that up on your own hardware, but there's also a free community server, which we can access with our Apple ID, and a monthly subscription tier called DrawThings Plus that allows bigger jobs, higher resolution, and longer videos. Today I'm showing an acceleration LoRa, CausVid for Wan2.1 text-to-video. It renders in 4 steps. I'll share my parameter settings, first using the small 1.3B model with the free community server, and then better quality using the larger 14B model at the DrawThings Plus paid tier. For the last section, I'll import a Wan LoRa and show a new feature in DrawThings that allows us to upload a LoRa to the cloud server. The developer calls it Bring Your Own LoRa. That's a paid feature, so only with the Plus subscription. And of course, if you have the hardware, anything with 16 gigabytes RAM or more, we can still render locally for free. Now there are 2 versions of Wan2.1, a large 14B model, and a small 1.3B. They're not the same, siblings, but not compatible. The CausVid models are fine-tunes of these 2 text-to-video models. Now the thing to remember about accelerated models, they aren't actually faster or smaller. They just render in fewer steps. The trade-off is that we have to flatten some parameters so they won't have any effect, and the steps the model needs to self-correct are all gone, so you will see more errors. Now, regular Wan spreads 20 to 40 steps across all the frames, but CausVid's trick is to limit the number of frames it pays attention to. It only needs a few steps, in this case 4, to generate a small section of the video, before moving on to the next section and the next. Now in theory, you could just keep doing this forever and generate a streaming video that is several minutes long. In reality, the CausVid models were trained on about 10 seconds and that's really all you're gonna get. Now the real advantage is we're rendering with 4 steps and that keeps the memory pressure low, regardless of how long the video will be. Now I'll start with a small model on iPhone. Later I'll show the large model on a Mac, but it's really the same either way. Search the LoRa Manager for CausVid and pick the 1.3B model. The LoRas are a small download, but we also need a full base model loaded in the model drop-down above. Now if you're rendering locally, these models will download and self-install. The 8-bit is compatible with the LoRa, but it will need over 9 gigabytes of free RAM. And remember, we have to leave room for the operating system. Now I'm signed into the community cloud, so I'm going to pick the regular model, not the 8-bit. And needless to say, this is not going to render locally on my iPhone. Now the CausVid LoRa only works with text-to-video models. There may be other CausVid LoRas in the future. Subscribe and I'll try to keep you up to date. We're gonna stay in the basic menu while we set these parameters. With the model and LoRa loaded, control is disabled. Strength is set to text to video. And I'm going to set a custom image size, width at 448 and height 768. It's roughly 9:16 ratio, and we may have more accurate resolutions soon. Set the steps to 4, number of frames to 81, that's 5 seconds and 1 extra frame. Set the text guidance to 1 exactly. Shift is 1 to 1.5, but keep it low. And for the sampler, choose a trailing sampler. I like DDIM trailing for animation styles. And you won't need to touch the advanced menu, but just in case you have, be sure the parameter for causal inference is switched off. The 1.3B model does not use this parameter. Now I'm using the Cloud Compute's GPU, which is NVIDIA, so I'll set the seed mode to NVIDIA GPU compatible. I'm signed in with my Apple ID, and the Cloud Compute is selected in the server settings. At the top of the basic menu, I see my compute units. I'm under the limit for the free server, with a little room to spare. And my text prompt. And now I can hit generate. The new progress bar will estimate the render time and other server information like the download's progress as we go. Now for the large model, swap the LoRa for CausVid 14B and choose one of the 14B text-to-video models. SVD Quant is great for rendering locally. It's nearly the same quality as the full version, but renders more efficiently. And notice the compute units have increased. It's a heavier model. I'm leaving the other parameters the same, but with the 14B model, I can make the resolution a little larger. For the width, I'm going 1024 and height 576. That's a true 16:9. But the important difference between CausVid Small 1.3B and Large 14B is under the Advanced menu. 14B uses the causal inference parameter. 1.3 has this calculation locked. We can't change it anyway, so for 1.3B, causal inference is switched off. But for the 14B, we need the parameter enabled and to choose the number of frames that CausVid pays attention to. It's chunks of 4 frames plus 1. If it's set too high, this setting will increase the memory pressure. And if it's set too low, the video will stutter and jitter. Now for local rendering, this can go high, as high as memory you have, and it will render in chunks of more frames, which will give more coherent motion, but at the cost of a lot of RAM. Locally, it was 35 gigabytes of RAM. But under the DrawThings Plus subscription, we have limited compute units, and 13 frames is a good starting point. The server will reject the job if it maxes out the memory. You won't see an error, it just aborts the render job. And I think that maximum is around 17 frames. Now for this last section, we'll import a Wan LoRa and put the link in the video description to a list on Hugging Face of compatible text-to-video LoRas. Now in the LoRa drop-down, up at the top, choose Manage, and I'll point the file to my Downloads folder, where I've already downloaded a few LoRa. As usual, we have an optional name. I like to add the model's name, just in case, and any other word that will make it easier to search. I always want to specify the model version. Do not leave it at automatic. In this case, I'm selecting Wan 14B. If you have any trigger words associated with the LoRa, add them as a prefix in the trigger word text and import. Now when I'm signed in to DrawThings Plus, I'm prompted to upload my LoRa to the cloud server. I have a limited file locker with my Plus account. I think it's around 10 gigabytes. And when it's full, I'll need to delete some of the files. The option when it uploads is to add a name of the LoRa so you know which files are being deleted later. And if you don't add the name, the LoRas are just a hash, so you won't know which is which when you need to free up some space. Now, of course, you can re-upload the LoRa later, so this is just for your convenience, like if you have some personal LoRas and you want to keep them handy on the server. Now, this feature is not just for one video, it's for any LoRa in DrawThings. can't upload a personal model, though, because it needs to already be on the cloud server to begin with. But the next time we sign in and use this same LoRa, it will be recognized by the server and pulled from your file locker. Now that's all we have time for today, so give this video a like if you think it's going to help other people, and subscribe to be notified of the next one. As always, I hope you had a learn, and I'll see you next time.